Hi there, I'm Caroline. I was just thinking back to this morning when I decided to have some fruit for breakfast. I knew I had 10 fruits in my kitchen. I looked around the kitchen and found this basket of apples and this basket of oranges. I know there are 10 fruits in all, but I'm not sure how many apples and oranges there are. So what should I do? Can I count one basket at a time? And if I found out how many are in each basket, what would that tell me about the entire amount of fruit I have? Let's find out. Before we get started, let's go over our goals for our lesson today. By the end of this lesson, you should be able to explain how the parts and the whole we use in math are connected. You should also be able to tell whether or not a number could be a part of a whole. We're going to start by learning what parts and whole are. Then we'll practice thinking about parts and whole. Let's start with those bowls of fruit we saw before. Now, we know there should be 10 pieces of fruit here in all, right? Let's count up this whole group to make sure that's right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. There are 10 pieces of fruit here in this whole group. Hey, that's one of the math words we're focusing on today, whole. The whole is the number that tells how many are in the entire group. In this group, the whole is 10. The number 10 tells how many apples and oranges there are together. But what if we wanted to know only how many apples there are or only how many oranges? Do you think we'd still be thinking about the whole? If you said no, you're right. Remember, the whole is the number that tells how many are in the entire group. If we focus only on the apples or oranges, then we're only thinking about a part. The parts are the smaller pieces that we can put together to make the whole. In this example, we have two parts that are making up the whole. Now take a moment to count to find out how many are in each of the parts. You can pause the video here while you count. There are 4 apples. That's one of our parts. There are also 6 oranges. That's another part. If we counted those parts together, we would find the whole 10. It doesn't matter if we count the apples or the oranges first, there would still be 4 apples, 6 oranges, and 10 pieces of fruit in the whole group. Let's look at another way of showing the part-part-whole connection between these numbers. This is called a number bond. It shows us how a whole is made up of the smaller parts inside of it. Remember what our whole was? 10. There were 10 apples and oranges in all. That whole was made of 2 parts. One of the parts was 4 apples. The other part was 6 oranges. This number bond is a way of showing how those 2 parts come together to make the whole. If you're able to, hold up your hands with me and I'll show you how I like to remember this. A number bond shows how a part and a part work together to make a whole. We can shorten this down to part, part, whole. Now here's the amazing thing about parts and whole. They help us think about numbers in all sorts of different ways. We've been thinking about our whole here, 10, as having a part of 4 and a part of 6. But do you think that is the only way to think about the whole of 10? Or could we break it into different parts? There is definitely more than one way to break a whole into parts. Here, let's put these fruits all together again and I'll show you what I mean. This whole group has 10, right? Well, forget about apples and oranges. Let's think about a different way to break 10 into parts. What if I told you that this whole of 10 is made up of two parts, fruits and vegetables? How many would be in each part then? You can pause the video here and think about this. All 10 of these are all fruits, right? That means 10 is one of our parts now. There aren't any vegetables in this group, just fruits. That means 0 is our other part. Our part of 10 here is the biggest part we can use to make the whole, 10. When we use 10 as one part, the whole group is in that part, so the other part must be 0. So our parts are 10 and 0. Those parts still work together to give us the same whole of 10. There are lots of different ways to break a whole up into parts. The important thing to remember is that the parts need to fit inside the whole. In mathematical words, they need to be less than or the same as the whole. That's why 10 is the biggest part we can use. It's the biggest number that can still be a part of the whole, 10. So let's think about a few other numbers. Could we use 5 as a part of 10? Yes, we could. If we break the whole of 10 into one part of 5, we can count to find that there would be 5 in the other part too. That means the parts 5 and 5 are another way of making the whole 10. What about 11? Could that be a part of 10? 11 is greater than our whole 10, so it cannot be a part of it. It wouldn't fit. Amazing work thinking about all these parts and whole today. Now, you know how parts and whole are connected. A whole is made of parts, and parts can be put together to make a whole. You should also be able to tell if a number could be a part of a whole. For example, could 2 be a part of 3? Well, 2 is less than 3, so yes, it could. We use parts and whole all the time in lots of different kinds of math. We'll start learning how to use parts and whole to solve problems in the next lesson. In the meantime, think about the numbers around you. You might just discover some more about how parts and whole are connected. See you soon! Hey, hey.